Hey guys, Mike from CCTV Camera Pros here. In this video, I want to tell you about how the team here designs long-range wireless bridge systems to connect security cameras at remote structures back to a centralized building and centralized recorder. So, for example, for some large residential installations, if someone has a detached garage or a detached barn, or maybe they have a gate entrance to their property, and they want to record those cameras back at their house, back at the main structure, and there's no wired connectivity run to those other structures. You can use these point-to-point or point-to-multipoint wireless bridges to connect those cameras back to the recorder. So let me explain a couple things first. So first of all, the kind of the difference between what a wireless bridge is versus a wireless network or wireless access point. So a wireless bridge is meant to connect two structures together, and the IP cameras in this case, but they could be other IP devices, are hardwired to a network switch. And then that switch is also connected to a transmitting antenna, and that transmitting antenna transmit via direct line of sight back to a receiving antenna. It's really like a last resort option for people that cannot run cable, either network cable or fiber, to between structures or buildings. So we've also helped a lot of commercial customers with multiple buildings on a single property connect cameras on the remote buildings back to their main building. So again, one recorder can record all of the IP cameras on their property. Now, this is just for network IP cameras. You can't use this with coax closed circuit cameras. These are basically to connect an IP network, so only IP cameras. And first I'm gonna talk about a point-to-point wireless bridge. So I'm gonna refer to this diagram here. And a point-to-point wireless bridge consists of a transmitting antenna or a transmitting radio and a receiving radio or an access point. And the transmitting antenna can have multiple IP cameras transmitting over it. And again, those are hardwired to a network switch. That switch is also wired to the transmitting antenna, and the entire contents of the network data that's on that switch gets transmitted back to the receiving antenna or access point. So we use this here at the office. We have a pole across the street from us where we have a LPR camera and two overview cameras. And just like this diagram, all three of those cameras are hardwired to a PoE switch. That's in a weatherproof NEMA box. And the transmitting antenna of the point-to-point wireless system is also hardwired to that network switch. So then on the receiving end of our building, we have the receiving antenna or the access point, and that's hardwired to our network router, as is the Viewtron NVR that's recording all the cameras. Now, also on our building, we have hardwired cameras, IP cameras that are hardwired back to the NVR, because the Viewtron NVRs have power over Ethernet. So the main building can have cameras hardwired directly to the NVR, PoE provided by the NVR, and that NVR is connected to the network router. That can also be a modem for internet access if you want to access your system remotely. That's very typical. And then the receiving antenna is connected also to that router. There can be a switch in between those two, but I wanted to make this as simple as possible. So that's how a point-to-point wireless bridge works. So a couple other notes about that. Point-to-point wireless bridge system is super long distance capable. This can go up to 3 miles with a direct line of sight. There can be no obstructions in between the two radios or antennas. And I use those terms interchangeably. Antennas and radios mean the same thing for wireless bridge systems. But there has to be a direct line of sight. Definitely no buildings in between, not even trees in between, literally direct line of sight between the antennas. And with the point-to-point system, the transmitter antenna and the receiving antenna have a 45 degree beam spread, basically 45 degree field of view wirelessly that you can connect to. And the more direct that is, the more strong the signal is gonna be. 150 megabits is the bandwidth that can be handled on that system. So what does that mean in practice? Well, a typical 4K IP camera is gonna use somewhere between 5 and 12 megabits of data. If you have it pumped up all the way to 30 frames a second at full 4K resolution, let's just say for simplicity, that's gonna use 10 megabits of data. So in practice, you could have 15 4K IP cameras transmitting over a single wireless bridge, a single transmitter back to a receiver. Now, that's if the setup is perfect. I mean, a perfect direct line of sight, there's not a bunch of Wi-Fi interference from the surrounding area, there's no trees obstructing the view, it's absolutely perfect. That's best case scenario. That is a point-to-point wireless bridge. Again, just one single structure or point pointing back to the access point or receiving antenna. Now, let's also talk about point-to-multipoint wireless bridge systems, and we'll refer to this next diagram. The difference here is you can have multiple transmitting antenna sites transmitting back to a omnidirectional, a 360 degree receiving antenna. And we use a different radio connected to that antenna that can handle 450 megabits of transfer. So that's so you can handle multiple transmitters back to it. So for example, if you wanna have one building that has 5 IP cameras transmitting back and another that has 5 or 7 and even a third, that omnidirectional receiving antenna and radio can handle all that bandwidth. So point is the access point and multipoint are the structures transmitting back, or the antennas rather, transmitting back to the access point. So the diagram is similar, except there's multiple transmission stations. So I have 2 poles on this diagram, one with 3 IP cameras going back to a network switch, and one with 2 IP cameras going back to a network switch. Both of them are using the same transmitting antenna from our Wi-Fi EN95610 system, which comes with the receiving antenna and a 360 omnidirectional antenna, and then 2 transmitting antennas. And we can add additional transmitting antennas onto that system if you have more than 2 transmission sites coming back to the access point. And again, back at the omnidirectional or the receiving side, you can also have hardwired cameras there going directly back to the NVR, hardwired power over Ethernet. So locally at the main building, everything's hardwired back to the NVR. And at all the transmission sites, those are going through network switches and then transmitting antennas back to the omnidirectional antenna. In the end, this is all seamless. It's all seen as just part of your network. And the team at CCTV Camera Pros designs these and pre-configures them for customers before we even ship them out. So let me talk about a couple other things. So in regards to the point-to-multipoint network, the one thing that you do lose is distance. So while the point-to-point system, you could go up to 3 miles, the point-to-multipoint with the omnidirectional antenna is really limited to about 1,500 feet. So the transmission distance goes down drastically, but most of the customers we're working with, it's a single property and you're not going distance of miles and miles. I mean, we have a few customers that use it that way, installers that do this professionally, but most of our customers, it's just a large property with multiple structures on it. What else did I want to mention? So I mentioned the receiving side on the omnidirectional is 450 megabits. So again, let's just do some simple math. If you have 4K IP cameras, each transmitting 10 megabit roughly, 10 times 45 is 450. So you could have 45 4K IP cameras on the point to multipoint bridge system. Now again, that's best case scenario, absolute direct line of sight, no interference, no trees, no obstructions whatsoever. Guys, If you have any questions about anything I talked about here or anything in regards to video surveillance equipment, you could always email me directly at mike@cctvcamerapros.net. If you want to learn more about how we use these point-to-point and point-to-multipoint wireless bridge systems with our Vutron IP camera systems and see more demo videos, you could request a quote, you can request a free consultation, please visit www.cctvcamerapros.com/wireless. Thank you for watching.